Around the World with MS World. I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor, Chief Medical Correspondent. Back in 2009, I started doing videos with a flip cam, actually at Ekstrom's in Dusseldorf, Germany. And that's why I'm so happy to be joined here by Dr. Orhan Aktas, who is a professor of neurology and the head of the local MS center in Dusseldorf. Dr. Aktas, you talked today about anti-lingo. People at home have heard a little bit about it, and they're starting to hear about remyelination. Can you tell us a little bit more about it?
Yes, with pleasure. Lingo 1 is kind of an endogenous switch within the central nervous system in the brain and the spinal cord, which inhibits endogenous stem cells from remyelinating, from repair. Because we should remember that we have the possibility to repair demyelinated lesions by our own, by a local tissue-based stem cells. However, these tissue-based stem cells are inhibited by so-called blocking inhibiting switches. And LINGO-1 is such a switch inhibiting local stem cells from differentiating and from repairing the central nervous system after inflammatory demyelination. What happened now is that an antibody was developed targeting LINGO-1. This antibody blocks LINGO-1 and is able to neutralize the limiting effect, the inhibitory effect of this molecule.
So basically, a person in their own body has a switch that goes on and off to make stem cells make new myelin, and lingo turns it off, so anti-lingo turns off the off switch, so turns it back on.
This is totally correct. This is how we thought it could work, and according to our now new phase 2 trial, obviously it indeed worked.
This study is called Renew. This was looking at people with optic neuritis, correct? So people who have inflammation in one eye. And when they got anti-lingo, what happened? Did they get better?
Well, we investigated them with a sophisticated electrophysiological method called visually evoked potentials, VEP. And using this method, we were able to follow the patient and also remyelination. This means repair of the affected nerves. And what we saw was that those patients who received anti-LINGO-1 antibody, which blocked the blocker and by that switched on again remyelination, that those patients showed a recovery on electrophysiological rounds, as compared to patients who received a so-called placebo drug. This means they became sham infusions of a placebo medication.
So what does this mean now? This was a phase 2 trial. Now we know that we start out with preclinical, then we got phase 1, phase 2. Is phase 3 coming up?
I think this is the very good basis, the fundament, to now design phase 3 trials in order to investigate how to implement such a therapy in clinical practice. This study was an early phase 2 trial. It's a pilot trial and it was a proof of biology trial. This means we were interested whether it works at all or not. And now we have clear indication that this approach is indeed able to remyelinate. And now in phase 3 trials we have to find a new therapy design in order to see how repair could also be achieved in large patient populations.
Well, I want to thank you so much. This is very exciting to hear about how back in 92 we had no medications. Then we had our first FDA-approved medication, beta-seron, or in Europe, beta-feron. And now we're talking about repairing and remyelinating. And so it's just an exciting avenue that we're going to hear more about. I want to thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.